You're watching Rest TV, Woomula. Watching The Takeoff.
The Takeoff. The Takeoff.
On Rest TV.
House of Deering. It's not about the scar on my face, where I am in the race. I know I'm in the darkest place. I feel that space of the void and the stress. But you send your word to me. Faith is now part of me. In the darkest days when I'm feeling low, I hear a voice calling my name. You are beautiful. You are beautiful. And the apple of my eye, the beating of my heart, you are. You are beautiful. So beautiful. You're the beating of my heart, the apple. The winds and waves winds may blow my way, the storm waging war. But all this are come before you, 'cause nothing compares to you. Your word will never fade, it stays the same till the end. Oh, the joy of me of beholding you, I hear your voice calling my name. You are beautiful, you are beautiful, and the apple of my eye, the bending of my heart, you are, yeah. You are beautiful, so beautiful, you're the bending of my heart, the apple of my eye, you are, you are, you are. Your name is higher than all other names. You came from up above to die for me. So I know you were.
Last hour of the Takeoff, the round table. And in this hour is when we bring to you different people. But on Friday, we bring to you celebrities. The lady I have with me in studio is a celebrity that you are yet to know, and get to know even more and more. Good morning. Our conversation is going on our YouTube page, Rest TV. Please follow through and invite friends to be a part of the conversation and also to get to know who we have today in studio. Good morning, lady.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm okay. How are you?
Just introduce yourself and tell people what you do. Yeah.
I'm Michelle Chalisima is my name. I'm a graduate from Deje University, a civil engineer. What else do you want to know? Oh, I sing, by the way. Celebrity, blah, blah, but yeah.
Okay, so when I mentioned Michelle, everyone felt like, Michelle Obama, what's happening? Are we having Michelle Obama get into? Have you heard that quite a lot?
Yeah, many people like to, because she's, if you check YouTube, she's like the top on the list. Even me, I tried going on YouTube and I was like, Michelle and Michelle Obama showed up. But yeah, Michelle Chalisima, basically that.
Okay, I don't have a stage name. A little bit of your background, Michelle.
Background. Well, I'm 24, I'm 23, 24 this year. I'm a child, the last born in my family. We are quite many. I don't want to go into those details.
Okay.
It's okay. Yeah, but I've gone through Gayaza, SETA for HSC, then Deje University. I go to Fanero.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your background while you were growing up as a child, who are you like? You seem a little humble. People want to know. What were you like as a child?
I grew up alone. I have very many siblings, okay. But I grew up alone with my mom and dad. So most of the time I taught myself to have fun on my own. I used to play alone, run around alone, make jokes to myself, and then I was taken to boarding school quite early, okay. P1.
Oh.
I loved boarding school because it had friends and what. I was very stubborn, though my parents thought I was quite humble, but at school I was the loudest, the person who makes the most jokes, disturbs everyone, really.
So how did you live up to that? At home you're humble, and then at school you're the loudest. How, the two personalities, how did you manage through this?
Well, because at home no one was, my mom always had work and my dad often was not around. Mm-hmm. So many a times people would be like cousins from like my mom's side would be around home.
Okay.
But at school I had people would actually ignite that fire inside of me. So it was much easier. If I had friends at home really to play with, I would surely be stubborn.
So in other words, it was there, but you didn't have anyone to bring it out.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Michelle, your music journey, your music career, when did you start to sing?
I started to sing like in my S1, really. That's when I went open.
Okay.
Earlier, I was quite shy. I didn't think I would meet the standards, those funny thoughts young girls have, really. But then in S1, my school, we had like a talent show. Okay, not a talent show, it was like a Christmas production.
Okay.
Then I auditioned, and damn, guys, hey, you can sing. I'm like, what? Are you sure? I was quite shy. But then I met a girl who told me, hey, you can, like, those things of just encouraging someone. And she told me, yes, Michelle, you can sing, what. Then I started growing the talent and all. I joined the choir. We used to mess up a lot because, as you know, those things, you know what happens.
Yeah,
so I joined the guys' choir. Then I sang, but girls in that school used to sing. Like, it felt like the whole school used to sing. But through all that, I had to, like, grow the confidence myself, really.
Yeah.
Because at the end of that, someone will tell you, but the belief or the confidence comes more from your side.
Yeah.
Even if they worship you or throw praises at you and you don't have it within you, you will still stay the shallow person.
We have so many people that have a skill or a talent to do something, but they don't believe in themselves.
Yeah.
So, of course, there are quite a number of things you did just to encourage someone out there who has something and they just don't believe in themselves.
Exactly.
You know, just go ahead and, you know, encourage them in that area. Some of the things you do, you can share.
Okay. Personally, I think the time I started growing more was when I started getting serious about God.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you know how really scripture is encouraging. Okay, then in that stage, it was more of, you are good enough. I knew you in your mother's womb. Those kinds of things, which spoke, at a point. But then the real encounter came in when, all these trying to make it more like an experience.
Yeah.
Leave it like just reading it and all. That's when I actually grew. I was not really the best.
Yeah.
In my singing, I was not the person you'd always look out for.
Yeah.
But with time, I realized that I cannot be like you, Shifa. I can't. Even if I tried, even if I tried to sound like you, I cannot.
Yeah.
If I do try, I'll be a copy of you, which is a bit low.
Mm.
So I appreciated myself, really. Yeah. So the advice I give someone is to just embrace who you are, embrace the fact that you're different. My tone cannot be the same, especially for musicians, really. My tone cannot be the same like everyone else. But listen to people. I did a lot of listening to people. I listened a lot to, there's a lady called Claudia Isaki. She's not so popular, really. But her tone, I love the way she sounded. So I kept on imitating. And for some reason, you always cultivate, like in you don't know that you're doing it, but you pick out from her basket and you add to yours.
Yeah.
So you find yourself sounding really good. I'm talking mostly music, but also in school, doing the engineering and all. Oh, my goodness. It was quite a journey. I didn't do so well, but you know how you pursue something. You're like, you know what? I think I want to be an engineer. I don't care what I got, but I think I got to do this.
Okay.
And I went ahead and pursued it. I kept on encouraging myself. So sometimes it's not about quitting. If you like something, go ahead and do it. And if God is for you, which He is, He'll always open doors. He always opened doors for me. I was never the most qualified, but I found myself in those places.
Okay, so looking at what you pursued at university, an engineer, so many times when we see musicians, we don't really, you know, attribute them to going to school and do those big courses, you know? So for you, an engineer and a musician, they're quite different. How do you match up the two?
Ha. That one is a hard paper because God has been calling me. You know how He's very unpredictable.
Yeah.
Well, if you have, for example, like for me, as I was growing up, I didn't really know what I wanted. At a point, I wanted to be a pilot. I wanted to be a mechanical engineer, or, like, operate planes. You know those dreams we have as children.
Yeah.
But later on, I figured things I'm drawn to. I didn't like history. Actually, I didn't know what I wanted, but I knew what I did not want.
Okay.
I didn't like history. I didn't like geography. I didn't like all those other things. So I went for something that I knew I would stay awake in class. Right, it was hard. Mm-hmm. So I went ahead with that. So the engineering was something I saw myself, you know, I think I can do this. And I went ahead. The music was not in the picture.
Then it wasn't.
It wasn't.
Okay.
If you watch probably like a show or something and you're like, hey man, I would love to do that in your heart or in your spirit. You meditate upon that. But then God just drifts things around in a twinkle of an eye.
Okay.
So I found my interests shifting a bit. I started I got serious about this, like, you know how you pursue an experience with God, not just worship team bandana, no, but a real thing. And he found a way to draw me to the music, because it wasn't really in the picture. So the engineering came through. I started doing it. I continued doing it. Then I meet D-Rain along the way.
Okay.
And that's where the music now started sprouting up.
Okay, before we get to D-Rain, you spoke of, you know, challenge. So many times we don't want, you know, to be challenged. Mm. We don't want to, we want the easy things. We want to go the easy way. Mm. But, you know, as a young girl and your dream is to do engineering, so many of us, we want the easy things. Mm. What is the challenge in wanting to do the easy thing, but also what is the challenge in choosing to do the hard things for you to, you know, at the end of the day, face it?
Okay, personally, I, even if I don't have the gut to, I love to challenge myself in my spirit. I might not put, I'd never put it out there like, oh, I want to, but I always challenge myself. Many a times, yes, if someone would choose the easy way out because of probably what they think of themselves.
Okay.
But I've, along the way, I discovered that people have so much.
Mm.
People have so much to offer. They themselves don't know. So if God, like, I kept awake, I kept awake to myself. So whenever I felt a positive vibe from someone, I always went with that wind. Like, they always ignited that. So many a times, even if someone is not able, like, even if they feel like they cannot, they are not able enough, choosing the easier way is good enough, but will you be satisfied at the end of the day?
Okay.
If it happens that music takes over the engineering, well, at least I know I went ahead and did it.
Yeah, you challenged yourself.
I challenged myself to it, and I've done well. I cannot say I've, despite the previous background of not doing well, I went ahead to university, and I am proud of who I actually got out to be.
Okay.
Yeah, so I urge anyone out there, don't always choose the easy way out. Trust me, the moment you believe, okay, it's a faith thing. Faith comes by hearing.
Yeah.
Hearing by the word of God. So, and the only way to please God is by having that faith. You don't have to put it all over the place. Just speak it in your heart, go ahead with it. Engineering, I think my mom was not always, she was not in the place to pay for it. But I went through school and I finished without a debt on my pay slip.
Wow.
So really, you just, someone needs to be in a positive place all the time. And that comes by hearing the word of God, really.
Wow, you mentioned a powerful statement that, you know, you can choose the easy way, but at the end of the day, are you going to be satisfied?
Yes.
So sometimes, you know, we want to be satisfied when we are done with an assignment. Mm. But will that satisfy you if you choose the easier way? Now, D-Rain comes in the picture. We are now seeing that music on YouTube, on TV. What was that like?
Well, I met D-Rain. I was at campus in my year two. But he came to perform. I didn't even, you know how you see a celebrity and you're like, this guy is a celeb. You're like, I will not go and say hi, but you're a bit shy, but yeah. For some reason, God just always, just
he has his ways.
Just has his ways. I did not struggle a lot, because after meeting, I remember he came, and at that time, I was part of the organizers, really, but more in the worship department. So I did my praise and worship, blah, blah, blah. Then after that, he came and performed, and yes, he left.
Mm.
Along the way, he had a concert, a concert that is organized by Spirit Radio. I've forgotten. So he was performing, and I'm like, oh, by the way, yeah, that guy. Oh, I was in the same room with him, really. But I think he saw me, and he recognized me. So I was like, let me just go and say hi, because I've met him before. I'm like, hello. And we exchanged numbers.
Just to be sure, the moment you'd be like, that guy, was it about his music or you just liked that guy?
Well, but you know those first songs on Aliako? You know those, his first hits? Really, they had a certain vibe to them.
Yeah.
Even if you didn't want to dance, you find yourself grooving to him.
Mm.
Yeah, so I liked his music, really. Okay. I did not know much about him, so I didn't go much that side. It was more about music.
Okay.
Then later on, he invited me for a fellowship. Hey, my goodness. Have you gone to a place and your heart just settles because everyone in that room just has beams radiating off of them that I'm right now. I don't care what is happening. It's just me and my God. Guys were wailing. Guys were in corners in the room and crying. And in my heart, I entered that place and I was like, this is it. This is the place I am supposed to be.
Mm.
And I think that's the journey. That's where we started. I hadn't worked with him before.
Yeah.
I hadn't done any music with him, but that's the place. And I went ahead to join the fellowship. Because I used to go whenever I could. And then finally, I became faithful. And I stayed that side.
Okay.
Yeah. But working with him, our first song, that was like in my third year. I remember I was coming from internship. And then he's like, by the way, can you work on a song? I'm like, are you sure? Like, are you sure?
So your intention of joining the fellowship, was it, did you see that coming, that he would ask you to, you know, do a song with him? Or
it was, you know how God knows the hearts of his people? And he's a checker of hearts, really.
Mm-hmm.
Your intentions cannot be hidden. I wasn't really about that.
Yeah.
But I just kept myself there. I just kept myself there. Just, I love this fellowship. Mm. I love it. And plus, people were amazing. Guys were good. Guys had this fire. I loved surrounding myself with people who have the same cause with me, really. Or maybe they don't have to throw it all over the place. But they just had a certain love of God about them. They wanted something deeper. Mm. Not let's go pray and leave and maybe go happen, but something. There's that thing that happens when you find someone, you know how you go to church and you meet someone praying, but then you meet someone else praying, yeah? And they just, for some reason, this person causes you to go back home and you feel like, I need to do something
for
myself.
Yeah, yeah.
So those are the people that I met there. And every time, I wasn't really so prayerful, what, I was not so deep or what, but these guys just had that way, they keep on drawing you, come. Like there's more come. So yeah, my heart really wasn't really for the music. Because as I told you before, I wasn't, I didn't see that side coming.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that first song happens.
What's
the song? And also, what happened with that? How did you feel about it?
Ah, that song is so dear to me. I can say I love it. It's called Alive and Free. That's the first song I did with him. It's on YouTube. And even now, like, I always refer to it, actually, it comes easy because there's a way your first child, I've not had children, but of course, I call anything that is maybe your first baby, something that has come out of you or a first, like something that is going out to the world. So there's a way you get sentimental attached to it.
Mm.
So that Alive and Free, I was so excited. I remember he called me. Internship, so I came, went to studio, we did the song. In my head I was like, Michelle, you know, you've just done a song with D-Rain. Like I kept repeating the moment over and over again. Like I kept on sitting down and acting it, like I actually went and we did this. He wrote most of the stuff, but the fact that I'd voiced.
Yeah.
Being shy, insecure, first of all, was like an eye-opener. Yeah, so D-Wayne really opened my heart, my eyes to a lot of things. He believed in me a lot.
Mm.
You know, Shifa, one thing is we should always know, like, people have two sides to them.
Yeah.
I could be here, but I have things that I am dealing with. Some other voices that are telling me other things. But then there's this other voice that is actually telling me that, Michelle, you can actually do this. Yeah. But if someone, we should always thrive to always be on that other side. That even if things are going south with someone, just always chip in that and tell them, you know what, you are better than that. Actually, yes, you failed. Yes, sorry, that's so bad.
Mm.
But you can do better. It's not the end of the road. So D-Rain has done that for me. I remember the first time he told me, Michelle, you're going to be the best worshiper. Ah. You know how you hear
with
lights?
All the worshippers, you know.
Like, you're like you guys. You know what you're saying? You barely know me. Like, I know you've met guys that are good.
Mm.
But you just, you know, there's that kind of thing, even if, like, I've learned that now, like, we should always be on that other side of people.
Yeah.
Like, even if people are failing so bad, just always look for that car thing, even if they are good at the list of things.
Yeah. And encourage them in that.
Keep chipping it there. At the end of the day, they will see the light at the end of the tunnel, because at the end of the day, they are the light in the tunnel. Mm. Yeah.
So Alive and Free is the song.
Yes.
I hope Justin will get it for us as we go for the break. It will be the song that will play as we get there. But Alive and Free, then what comes next after that? Even like when you did this song, did you feel like it's something you're going to continue with, or it was just that and we are done?
Well,
what has come along the way after?
All right. Mm. Okay. Alive and Free, I know how you go by the wind.
Yeah.
Let's roll. Let's keep rolling. I don't know what's happening, but let's see what happens. So I did not expect more music, but the fact that this gentleman kept on telling me, you know how the scriptures say that when Mary was pregnant with Jesus, there are things that the Holy Spirit told her, yeah, that she kept in her heart. No one knew about those things.
Yeah.
But those are the things that telling me best worship, I'm like, oh, maybe something is coming up. Many a times, even if nothing was happening, I just take, let me not focus on that, but I know maybe something better is coming. The fact that he said that, I don't think he's crazy. Yeah. Yeah, so it's good to keep some of the positive confessions in your heart, or maybe things people tell you, because it's what keeps you going. So that's how more music came up. Our other song was, we did a couple of songs that have not been brought out. Mm-hmm. But I think God was after the process, because even that, he taught me patience, to rely on him completely.
Mm.
Because if someone is after something else, they would leave. Because sometimes we did songs, if you have a lot of anxiety, your heart will always betray you.
Okay.
Where your heart is, that's where your treasures are. So if your heart is somewhere, you will have the patience to stay there. You will have the zeal to actually stay there.
Mm.
You will have something to always push you, despite whatever is happening.
So how many songs have you done so far?
Ones that people know.
Yeah.
I have 3 singles. That is My Eyes on You, Papa, which is our recent video. Oh, it's amazing. Then I have A Miracle. Then I have I've done a lot, not a lot really. There are like 3 collabs with D-Rain. That is Alive and Free. I Am a Miracle. Then which other song? Then there's some other song that I don't remember right now. But
okay.
Yes, there are others that are still in studio.
Okay, so we are still with Michelle in studio. She's telling us her journey, how her journey has been. But also, when we come back, I want Michelle to tell us, why D-Rain? Why aren't we hearing her singing with other people? But also, what challenges is she facing as an upcoming artist? Because we believe she's going to be a big one at the end of the day. So let's see that song, Justin, Alive and Free, Michelle and D-Rain.
Tools like a remix, nobody can love me better. Jesus, you love.
Yeah, it's karma that awaits. Lick off the battle when you're weak, you know you're brave. The treasure is inside you, like a river flowing, let his peace flow around you. You make me sing this melody. Heal up my heart, my remedy. I cannot go on without you. In my life, I cannot.
When the world is falling apart, I just stand and hold on your word in my heart. You're a good, good father. Yeah, your love is all.
Brother, tell him about this life, a better love. Tap, 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 your brother. Make me sing some love song, make me sing. This song makes me feel like a DJ. On the ones and twos like a remix. Nobody can love me better. Jesus, your love.
In your presence, I'm alive and free. Alive again, alive again. This song makes me feel.
said, tap, 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 your brother. Tell him about this love, a better love. Tap, 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 your brother. Make me sing some love, so make me sing.
You're a good, good father.
The Takeoff.
The Takeoff. The Takeoff.
On Rest TV. You're watching Rest TV. Woomula.
Are you heavy laden and need to talk to a pastor? Then wait and call here on Rest TV Monday to Friday.
Hello?
Never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say never.
Watching Rest TV, Woomula. Watching The Takeoff.
The Takeoff. The Takeoff.
On Rest TV.
song is Papa from Michelle Chadisima. Now, someone out there will be wondering, usually in studio there's auto-tune and those things. So people would be thinking, it could be a little auto-tune. So just, you know, to give us an a cappella of that song, please.
Enimizawa sacha chazimala okutotola Nzenkawa olusi wenzi chukire chisacho Zeo mukwano kwa gunzi buwalira okunyonyola Gweweta golo zeko omanye ono tata gwenina.
Wow, you have a beautiful voice. Aww. Very beautiful. How do you do it? How do you, and also what I want to know is why gospel music?
Why gospel
music? With your voice, you know, I know so many people out there are looking actually to come to you. I don't know if you've had those people coming to you to ask, you know, to come into this other world. Why gospel music?
Why gospel music? Wow, that's a very interesting question. My life has really been about God.
Okay.
Has been about God entirely. I've always wanted to be the person that draws out. Music is good. I could actually sit down and actually write an inspirational. But for some reason, God just wired my heart to love him. Really. I sit down and I'm like, can I sing a love song? Yeah, I could. Everyone is doing that. Maybe I will sing one. Maybe. Okay. Could be. But why gospel music personally, it was where my heart was.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you had, you know, people coming to you from the secular world and they're offering a lot of money to you to, you know, go out and probably do a collab with, let's say, who? Cindy or Sheba. Would you go for it?
No, I wouldn't.
Why?
Why? Because they are good. We appreciate them, what they are doing.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, I don't know if I could. I listen to some. I know a few songs of Cindy, Sheba.
Mm-hmm.
But personal taste, I wouldn't. And the money has really not been the thing that has been in the picture.
Okay.
Growing up, there was not a lot of money, really. So I taught myself.
Okay, so money is not in the picture. So many of our young people in church, musicians, instrumentalists, we've seen them do gigs because to them, the money is out here.
Yes.
In church, we don't see the money because, you know, you are in church and you're doing gospel music just to, you know, have something to say to our young people because we've had so many of them leave church because of the money that is out in the gigs.
Well, there's a time in my life, actually, I was in a band. And we were venturing into gigs. Yeah, we had started venturing into wedding gigs and all. Eh, I remember the first time they gave me my command. I think it was like 250. I held it, I was like, Holy Spirit. I was excited. I remember, I think in my first year. Ah, my goodness. Mm. But I did like another gig, but for me standing there and singing songs while people are eating, or not really paying attention, I feel like that is a lot of work for me. I'm quite shy, hard to believe, but yes, I'm quite shy. Mm. So standing there and singing, Nakupenda Malaika, you know, like, was not really something I was really into. So yes, I did, and I got the money, but I used all the money, I think, 2 days after. Mm. So I was like, I feel like, yes, if I started this journey, it would be good. I know it is very nice to have some money in my pocket.
Yeah.
But then the feeling I have while doing those was not really the satisfying one because I always referred back to it. I was like, I don't feel content enough. So gigs, yes, I did try gigs, but they didn't work for me. And for some reason, God always brought people around me that had the same mentality. I remember that band, yes. For some reason, they're the ones who pulled out. Mm. They're like, yes, we do, but there was a gospel band called Musical Solace, a group of young people that I used to work with. And they just had this about them also. They were about, let's go to church, minister. Yes, they give us our transport, we go home. Yeah. But at the end of the day, we go back feeling like, I feel like I've challenged myself. I messed up while singing the lyrics, by the way. But the fact that someone came and told me, Michelle, you've ministered to me, that was enough to take me back home happy.
Wow. Now, to our brothers and sisters who are in the gig world, we know of people who come to church Sunday play, mm. but on a Monday or Tuesday are in a bar mm. playing for, you know, an event. Mm. I don't know what your take is that, what your take is on that, and also what you have to tell them in that moment.
Well, gigs are not bad, I think, my opinion.
Yeah?
They ain't bad. But it's about you. There's a scripture that says, if you go out and if a man is chasing their life, they will lose it. But if a man chases God, they will seem as if they are, I'm paraphrasing, seem as if they are losing their life, but at the end of the day, they will gain it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if a person is doing gigs, and truthfully, I cannot say for them. I can only say from what I know. That's their way. They are probably chasing the money. But in my experience, I have not gotten a lot of paying things, really. But I sought God. My heart, okay, surely. Surely was really, I went with what my heart always felt like. So if a person still finds fulfillment, I will not push them, please don't, no. Mm-hmm. Please go enjoy the gigs. When your heart is drifted, or you find, because at the end of the day, yes, you'll play the gigs, come back home, buy your screen, you feel good, go back for another one, buy yourself a cooker. But there are weightier things than that. Mm. At the end of the day, there are weightier things. And I've seen very many talented people go, and their aim is the money. Someone cannot come to church and sing because they're not given transport.
Mm.
God will always test us beyond.
That's true.
He will always squeeze it out of you. Mm. And he shines the light even when you don't know. Like, he'll always shock you and put a torch where you thought you were okay. Kumbe, you are just acting it or faking it.
Okay, so many, like I asked before we broke off, why House of Duran? I know it's Duran you met first and you did projects with him. You're still doing projects with him. I know there are producers that would want to, you know, have you assigned to them, or I don't know if you've also felt that way, that you want to go elsewhere. Why House of Duran?
I always refer back to that fellowship place.
Okay.
House of Duran, let me give you like a short brief about House of Duran. House of Duran is a group of young people, like any normal fellowship. Oh, but yeah, any normal fellowship that has guys who are passionate about God. So you come to someone and be like, man, I have no transport. That is enough to get you. You just call. There's a friend of mine, she's called Rachel. Rachel, Chidi Bubi, man kandave. Then also, so you call this man Chidi Bubi. Like, it's a family. We are people that have grown to love ourselves.
Mm.
Guys are very talented, but mostly their heart is about God. And funny enough, kuba kalangu, but no. Yes, yeah, so I'm working with how it became a House of Duran.
Mm.
It became a family. We started off big, but people left due to reasons, but of course they come back this time. But people are very talented. People are very God-loving, and yeah, that's how it's House of Duran.
We know of musicians that are signed to certain, let's say, producers or managers or certain labels, and they have limits to do certain things. Mm. Do you have limits?
Yes, I do.
How does that work? Okay, do you mind sharing to us some of the limits?
Well, as a manager, Duran is my manager. There are things you sit down, but he's not... usually, some people, I think, get to work with people because of the money. At the end of the day, if someone gives you a good deal, by the way, they want to sign you. There's someone who came to me sometime, they wanted to sign me, give me a house, get me clothes, give me makeup money, kaviri money. The offer was
juicy.
But you're not working with someone and you learn their heart. Yes. Me, I always felt, we watch a lot of movies.
Yeah.
Movies have preached the gospel. You work with an artist, they use you, later on their dreams change, then they take you to a circuit, da 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 da. Ah, yeah, me, I didn't want that for myself. And thank goodness God brought me, D-Wayne. D-Wayne is about God, and he's a very, you hosted him last time, he's a very deep man of God.
Yeah.
So my limits, for some reason, are very well reversed with his. Like, he was not a person who will squeeze you to do something you don't want to do. Okay. At the end of the day, it's not that I want to perform at a gig, or it's not something that I want to maybe sing with someone. Well, he has a say. He has a say, and he will explain to you why not. So really, it's not about I feel enclosed or I am uncomfortable. No, I have understood his heart and where we are going. And many a times I didn't know where we are going, but I went by his whims, and I was happy at the end of the day. So I have learned to trust him, trust his judgment, and thank God he has a heart of God.
Wow. I know, Michelle, this journey is still ongoing. It's new. It's new challenges, and, you know, here and there. What have been some of the challenges you faced so far? Because I know major ones are coming along the way. We are not praying for them, but it's not always smooth. But what have been some of those challenges, and how have you maneuvered through?
Challenges. Let me say, usually the thing that makes one able to go through a challenge is the mindset they have about the challenge.
Yeah.
And in fellowship, thank God for the word. Yeah. Some people think it's cliche, or because they have heard maybe preachers talk about you need to be positive, and that's the deal. Or they keep on saying these good things about God. But once you experience God a certain way, you know, Shifa, we can be Christians, born again.
Yeah.
Nicodemus was a born, he was a Christian. But the day he met Christ and they had that conversation, God showed him that you are wanting. And he got born again that day.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the mindset one has during the challenges, challenges are there. There's a morning you wake up and surely check your bag. There is nothing.
Mm.
But you have to wake up, thank God for this word.
Yeah.
They preach to you and they're like, the day you sleep hungry, Nyuma, Kesale, that dress, take a cup of that to come out, you get.
Mm.
So challenges have always been there, and yes, as I'm growing into this thing, I have been briefed. The word warns you about it.
Yeah.
It tells you, by the way, as we are going in this journey, men are going to come. Mm-hmm. Atesh, if I don't ask any questions.
We are going to go there, of course.
Men are going to come. Mm. Money deals are going to come. But what happens? We have examples like David. We have examples like all these Bible characters that we have in the scriptures. But each one of them, if you're not focused on detail, you never notice that these guys had challenges.
Yeah.
You might think, oh, David was always victorious. After he became king, he was happy.
Mm.
You know, he had a happy life. But no, in there, he struggled a bit. There are times he woke up and he didn't feel good enough to be king. But he got up and maybe stood on the balcony and told people, there is a God and you need to bring that ark home. You get. So the mindset one has, and that mindset can only come from the word.
Yeah.
I'm not saying I'm the most prayerful, I'm not saying I'm the most what, no, I'm not all those things.
Yeah.
But there's just a way the comfort comes from the word. I go back home sometimes and all these things are going bad, I have a very bad day. But the scripture has told me I am the righteousness of God. Today is better than tomorrow. There is always these things that are there that are good enough, but you choose. People will say, maybe you choose to muri mwebzabza. But no, there is a place you reach and it's not about mwebzabza.
Mm-hmm.
God shows you the real deal. There is a permissible and perfect will. He will show you that there is this will that, yes, you can go. The permissible is where you choose to settle for less. Perfect, trust me, the perfect will, Catherine Kuhlman says, will cost you everything.
Yeah.
It will squeeze that pride out of you. Sometimes it hurts. Challenges whereby money, I'm most using money because it's the most common. Really, you come and tewali. But you have to look good. You have to smile at a Michelle. Oh, my goodness.
Mm.
But then other times you don't have the things that you actually need, but you have to go through it. All these things, I keep reminding myself that it's just temporal. I am in the perfect will of God.
Yeah.
There's a time that is going to come and I will have more than enough money. But at the end of the day, it will not be about the money.
Yeah.
It is about the word that is behind the money, the gospel behind it.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow, that's beautiful. Now, your music, who writes your music? Do you write your own music?
D-Rain does. D-Rain does write most of the music.
Okay.
But not only does he write, but he also teaches. He has taught us to, you know, there's writing. Anyone can write.
Yeah.
I cannot say I don't write. There's a time I took my songs to him. Panange mpande sakaimba. Na kutunu yangama, very good. Then you never talk about it. Yeah, we never, I'm like, hey, but you guys, didn't you hear my writing? Didn't you hear my song? I wrote you a song.
Mm.
But at the end of the day, you asked me a question earlier, why do I choose to work with him?
Yeah.
This man has called me, like, not only does he help me with the music, but he has some sorted that, like my writing. I can sit down and write, yes, unkwakala. All those things. We can write all, anyone can sit down and write. But you know, God has been so gracious that you can write a song without the understanding of it, the real, you might think you understand.
Yeah.
But then there is the real understanding behind it. That is, those are the songs that actually last. When you have like a Don Moem sings, maybe Lord I Give You My Heart, or maybe any of those, Darlene, they write a song. Yes, as worshippers, we might sing it. But if someone does not have the real, the depth
of the song.
Mm-hmm. You might just speak it. That's the same thing with writing. So I've been improving my writing. I have written a couple of things that I have not really gotten mic to sing yet.
Mm-hmm.
But I like the process, the fact that I am getting better. Now I can write from a point of understanding. If you watch a few, maybe Hillsong,
mm-hmm.
Maybe you'll see them write, they'll talk about their writings. It's not about just, guys go out to an island for months to write one song. What are they doing there? That's like months, 8 months, someone is writing King of Kings, something like that. And like, meaning there's something more. So yes, Ewan writes most of the songs.
As we wind up, Michelle, who is that artist you'd want to, you know, be on the same stage with if you were given chance?
I think Sinach.
Sinach. Okay. This program is on YouTube. I hope it will get to Sinach. Michelle would want to be on the same stage with you sometime. I want you to share with us an experience as we wind up. Mm-hmm. Something that, you know, is going to challenge somebody, but something that you've experienced yourself.
Okay.
Mm.
This is mostly for worshippers. Everyone is a worshipper. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Everyone is a worshipper. Not about the voice. Really. Gig men, hoo-hoo. Anyone who is about God, or even those that are not. There is so much to God. There is so much to God. Like, many a times, my walk experience, yes, that was the question. I used to walk as a Christian, and I thought I loved God. But until I just encountered God, there's a song that we have, it's called Sweet Holy Spirit. I remember, D. Wayne wrote that song. I produced it, I sang, voiced it. My goodness. Then we played it because I remember we were going somewhere after that with a few people in the ministry somewhere. I listened to it like a few hours. We got home. I'd never experienced this before. On the song that I just sang, I cried for like an hour and a half because for the first time the words made sense. But he told me that the songs that you write are not, they you might think you're ministering to other people, but mostly to you. Because God is calling you to a bigger place. You might think you're there, but you're not yet. The scripture says, to know God, knowing God, it's eternal life to know God. Eternal life is to know God.
Yeah.
Meaning that he's endless. Everything around us can speak about God, but if you're dead to those things, you'll never realize what's happening.
Yeah.
So be awake. Let just exercise your spirit to be awake to those things, because God is always speaking, and there is so much more. He will give you. There is so much more he's willing to give you. There is so much that is actually available to you. But if you're not awakened, you'll stay in the same place over and over again.
Wow, thank you so much, Michelle. What song should we sign out with? Your favorite song?
You've played it, but yes, Papa is my favorite song.
Okay, so we'll sign out with Papa. Thank you so much for coming through and for sharing so much wisdom and for being here with us today in studio. Thank you so much for being a part of the Takeoff Show. The weekend is coming and the baddest youth show here in town, in Uganda, East Africa, the Youth Hub, will be on tomorrow with the Drip Sensei. So you don't want to miss that out. Keep watching Rest TV. We love you. We'll sign out with Papa. And later, Justin will also play for us the funny video of the day. Thank you so much for being a part of the show. We love you. Good morning.
Heheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheh